Hello, fellow gamers. I just want to take a few moments to explain to you why Red Dead Redemption 2 is not realistic. This game just came out about a week ago, and the internet is fucking exploding over how realistic it is. You can walk around in the snow and you leave a trail behind you, but one of the weirdest, craziest things that has people talking is how your horse just randomly takes shits as if it would in real life while you're walking around. A virtual shit is not realistic. I can take a real shit. What does that make me? Fucking an omnipotent being like Q from Star Trek? I can just wish something into being and it happens? Like, oh, I feel like taking a shit right now. Oh, there it is. That's fucking realistic. A virtual horse shit is not realistic. You use the game with a regular controller. You want to fight somebody, you just start mashing the square button and your character starts punching people or triangle grabs or whatever the buttons do. That's not realistic. I don't just see somebody on the street and I want to fight him. I just, oh, let me press the square button on my phone. Oh, I'm magically fighting him like fucking Mike Tyson. No, that is a video game. You can say it's fun all you want. You can say it's very entertaining, but it's not realistic. Let me tell you what is realistic. Virtual reality. It's there in the name. Reality. Realistic. Now, I know some of you guys are going to start talking shit right now because you've seen some videos from the dev kits from 2 years ago. The consumer version of virtual reality, the HTC Vive and the Oculus Rift, have been out for 2 years now. The first wave of games that came out, yes, they were stupid little tech demos. You just sat in a spot. There were wave shooters. You just aimed a gun and shot. There was nothing interactive. That was 2 years ago. There are some great, amazing games that come out now where if you want to shoot a gun, you have to actually hold the gun up. You have to line up the sights like a real one. If you want to reload, you have to manually take the magazine out. You have to put a new magazine in. You want to throw a grenade, you have to pull the pin out. You have to throw the grenade. That's realistic. Not a video game that you play on a TV screen. But actually, you know what? Now that I think about it, Red Dead Redemption 2 really is realistic. And let me explain why. It is a symbol of realism for how game companies care more about money than they do their own customers. What I mean by that is this game came out, it doesn't even have multiplayer. Just like when GTA 5 came out, they're going to add the Red Dead Online a month or two from now. But they're going to charge your ass for the full price now. That is a realistic symbolism of how companies care more about green dollar bills than they do about their own customers. You guys think that people like Rockstar are your friend? They're not. They're a business. I understand that the game might be a labor of love, of passion. These guys really are gamers in them. And don't get me wrong, Rockstar makes great games. All their games are blockbuster hits. They're making sales records. And I don't think they're putting out a shitty product by any means. But giving you a game that's not fully finished and telling you they'll add to it later, but wanting your money now, that is fucking greed. And they could wait another month or two to have the entire package. And you guys are just lapping it up like stupid little dogs. But that's all companies are. They're run by board of directors, they're run by investors, and they want money more than they do want customers' respect. And that is sad. You guys deserve better, and I think that you guys should support companies that support you as gamers and as respect you as consumers. But that is the true symbolism of what the realistic feeling in Red Dead Redemption is, giving more care about the customer's money than the actual customers. Thanks for watching.